Hello, this is Ms. Pneumatic here. Today, we're going to learn about how to read the drawing symbols of the pneumatic directional control valve. You can see these drawing symbols in a catalog of a pneumatic product. The reason of using the drawing symbols is to allow users to easily guess what a certain device does and how it works only by looking at the simple symbols. It may not be easy to find out what the given device does only by looking at its external part. By referring to the drawing symbols, however, you can easily figure out that it is a manual valve or it works by a solenoid just by looking at them. Today, we will learn about the drawing symbols found in the directional control valves. If you're yet to be familiar with the basic operating principles of the pneumatic valves, I recommend that you watch the solenoid valve video shown above before watching this one. All right then, let's begin with the most basic symbols. First, I'm going to draw a square. This square is a symbol that displays the position of a control valve. This is called a position. Second, the number of squares attached with another refers to the number of valve switching positions. In other words, it's called two position if there are two squares, and three position if there are three. Third, the flow path and the closed circuit symbols are marked inside the positioning symbols. A straight line indicates a flow path, and an arrow displays the direction in which the fluid flows. The T symbol marks the closed circuit in a right angle. The arrow symbols indicate the flow path of the fluid from which port to which it travels, while the closed circuits represent a blocked flow path where the fluids no longer flow. Fourth, the contact part of the flow path is marked with dots. And the external piping connected to the valve is shown in a straight line outside the control valve symbol. Fifth is the port display symbol. The working port is drawn above the square, while the power port and the exhaust port are displayed below the control valve display symbol. As you can see from the table, there is numerical and alphabetical notation. The alphabets were used in the past, but it's more common to use numerical notation nowadays. The main power port of the fluid is displayed as 1 or P, while the working port shall be in an even number, which is 2, 4, or A, B. Exhaust ports are labeled in odd numbers, which are 3, 5, 7, or R, S, T. Let's look at several examples about the number of ports. 2 port displays the number 1 on the power port and the number 2 on the output port. 3 port indicates 1, 2, and 3 on the power port, working port, and exhaust port, respectively. 5 port shows the 1 on the power port, 2 and 4 on the working port, and 3 and 5 on the exhaust port. Out of the drawing symbols we saw, let me compare the drawing symbols on the 5 port with the internal structure of an actual valve. This is a drawing of a cropped body part of the valve. The supply fluid is displayed as the working port 2 after going through the power port 1. The consumed fluid goes through the work port 4 to be discharged through the exhaust port 5, and the port 3 is blocked from fluid flow. That's it for today. Today, we learned about the basic drawing symbols and port notations of the directional control valves. In part 2, we will learn more about the fluid flow path changes when switching position symbols, along with the various operating symbols of the valves. This is only the most basic summary, so please go and watch part 2. If you think today's video was useful, please subscribe and give a thumbs up. Please leave comments below if you have any questions. I'll see you all in the next video. Thank you! Ms. Pneumatic Channel is working together with KCC Precision.